All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sport Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming to you live from Portland, Oregon. Wow, we got a lot to chat about tonight. We're doing old school sports chat, roundabout. A bunch of stuff to talk about. It's Thursday night. Wife is working. Yard is perfect. I literally blew every single leaf off of the yard. Doesn't that feel good? It's a little dry in Portland. Oh, so good. That's some wild stuff to talk about, okay? Thursday night football was an absolute banger. Went right down to the wire. Good question, you know, do you go for two or not? That kind of stuff. Tuesday night live stream got a little off the rails. Got a little negative at times there. Apologize for that, some of that. But I didn't really share too much of my personal thoughts on the 12-teamer. Had Big Ten Ted in. Big Ten Ted's an absolute legend. And again, if you're interested in the live streams are great. Tuesday nights, 5:30 to 7:30 Pacific Coast time. But I didn't really get my thoughts on it. Oregon dropped the uniform combination. They're going with the retro. Well, God, it just looks so good. For all the old-timers, we love this one with the yellow pants. And gray. Okay, so anyway, we'll talk about some of this stuff. And then this crazy story of the guy who works at U of O talking about Trump voters, go jump off a effing bridge. We got to hit this. This is a big story. So all these things, we're going to try to wrap this up in about 10 minutes, okay? First and foremost, love the jerseys. We knew this was going to drop. Shout out to Quinn Van Horn. He was in here earlier talking about all these different jerseys and how good are these, right? The classic. And, you know, feel good, play good. Look good, feel good. Feel good, play good. That's usually how it works. I feel like this is going to be a really good game against Maryland. Maryland is a team that does have, with the big Under Armour deal, kind of a flagship with their uniform and with their Under Armour connection. And their uniforms are pretty crazy. A lot of them get pretty wild. So should be a fun game. I loved their video where they talk about it never rains at Autzen Stadium. And then it says, forecast this weekend, rain. I love that. And then a 12-team playoff, you know, number one team in the country. The first week of the 12-team playoff, to be able to have that ranking coming in here, this is a big deal, and I think the Ducks are ready for it. I've really completely switched gears to the real belief side here. Again, no offense to this specific team. It's kind of an overall malaise of Duck history where you don't need to try to go so far in that you think everything is going to happen and then possibly it gets burned. I still believe there's a tremendous amount of competition out there, and I don't think there's one clear-cut number one team, but it looks to me like right now the two best teams in the country are Oregon and Ohio State. And I would say Georgia's in that conversation as well. I would say Miami might be in that conversation. I would say that's why you play the 12-team playoff. But for those complete teams, it looks like those are the top three, four. And so, again, let's break down this 12-teamer. I think it's awesome the way it sets up. Boise State in the top 12 to start the thing is a big deal. I get it. BYU seems slighted a little bit. Indiana might seem slighted a little bit, being that undefeated. But this year, the committee has proven they're always going to put teams with one loss ahead of undefeated teams. They've done it all year. And so they're going to put Ohio State with one loss at the two spot. They're going to have Miami at 9-0 at the four spot. And again, in the old BCS, undefeated is king system, that's how it would be. This is a different system. It's also a completely different style of being able to rank the teams and then think, where would these teams be seated? Those are two totally different conversations, which we'll continue to have as you go through it. And again, every week I talk about the Ducks, obviously. I talk about the top 25, and I talk about the Big Ten. In the top 25 video, it's basically this. It's basically breaking down the top 25 each week, and then as you get closer and closer, it gets closer to the top 10, top 15, or whatever the case may be for this year. So it's an exciting time, and I do think Maryland's going to have fun out here. I don't think it's going to rain that much. I think if it does rain, it's going to rain late. The Beavs are playing earlier in the day. The Ducks are playing at 4:30. I don't know exactly what it is. I think it's 4. It should be a great day of football in the Valley, and it really hasn't turned yet. The weather really hasn't gotten cold yet. you know, when I was out in Detroit last week, that was what everybody was saying. They said, God, it hasn't even gotten cold yet. It was 70 degrees damn near on Halloween. And so it feels kind of that same way out here. The rains are coming. We know they're coming, but they haven't hit really quite yet. So that's why my yard looks so good. My grass looks awesome. I've been top dressing with the sand. I mean, if you know what I'm talking about, you know what I'm talking about. If you know, you know, when it comes to growing grass. And we do grow some pretty good grass out here in Oregon. So 12-teamer looks absolutely awesome. I know that everybody goes immediately to, well, this team versus this team. It's the first week. Just know that right now they have Boise State in that 12, which means they don't need to have an argument to get in any way, shape, or form. They are in. And then not only that, but they are also at the point where they could start to possibly jump other teams and get in a higher seating than the 12 spot, right? So I think that's kind of the idea is that, you know, Boise State has a lot going on right now. Their only loss is to Oregon, and that's a game they basically could have or maybe should have won had Oregon not come back, but they didn't. Oregon came back and won that game, but it was a very tight game, and that Boise State's a good team. So, okay, let's talk about this story. Holy crap. You know, politics get crazy, man, and you see it every year, and I'm not a political guy. I don't live my life with politics driving my decisions or any of that sort of stuff in any way, shape, or form. I'm a history teacher. I'm a social studies teacher. So it's part of my gig to be locked in and know what's happening politically, right? But I am very independent, partially because of being a government teacher for 20 years or 15 years. I mean, I've been a teacher for 20 years, but I don't teach government every year. But I love teaching government. And one of the key concepts I teach about in government is the ability to agree to disagree. I mean, you got to agree to disagree. And, you know, so this guy works for the U of O. He's got duck gear on. This was the biggest offense that I took. The biggest offense I took was he's wearing duck gear while he's spouting off all this stuff in this video. And you know what? It's just, I think there's a crazier thing. I have a YouTube channel, obviously. I talk into a camera and I say things and I try to keep it 100. I try to be very transparent and honest of my thoughts. But why would these people it doesn't matter what political side you're on, feel the need to scream and yell and threaten people or tell people to, you know, jump off a effing bridge? That is so why it seems so opposite of the people that they're trying to be. I'm a loving person, man. I'm a guy who I want what's best for people. I work with kids. I'm a high school teacher. I've worked with kids for 25 years. I've been a high school teacher for 20 years. I've coached basketball. I've coached every sport you can imagine, basically. It baffles my mind that there are people who are working with youth and working with kids who have such negativity going on in their life. Like, I can't believe this, some of this stuff. And the politics brings up such negativity with these people. So that's why I've been on YouTube now for 15 years. I've 14 years or whatever it's been. I've never tried to get political. I've never tried to get negative with people. I've never tried to yell and scream at people and make it a personal issue or any of that sort of stuff. But these people that are going on saying that they can't have a relationship with their friends and family and how, you know, the president is going to divorce their own family and stuff. And I've seen it with my own family and friends where I've seen people literally break up over politics. I mean, politics doesn't care that much about you. Why are you caring so much about politics? And I'm a politics guy. I'm a history teacher. I teach about this stuff. It's crazy to me. So this guy, Leo Soretto, and he immediately is now canned, and they're completely flaming this guy. I mean, millions of people are retweeting his thing. I saw it on Twitter, and then I saw it on the Daily Emerald. And I thought the Daily Emerald did a really good job of saying exactly what happened. The guy's in a leader in the fraternity group. What is he? He's the assistant director of fraternity and sorority life. Okay. And it's just crazy to me that these guys, and it's not just him, but it's a lot of people who get so emotional about these topics that it takes over their life. And I've always kind of thought that Sports Chat 503, what I try to represent here is to be passionate about the Ducks. And, you know, I'm never going to be all angry and upset or whatever about this stuff, because it's just a game. And these elections and stuff, people make it out to be a much bigger deal, I think, than it is. And they get a little too wrapped up in it. But it made me think of this thing that happened in my chat this week, where a guy came in, Buckeye Bob, shouts out to Buckeye Bob. He came in, and just a troll guy coming in, saying stuff or whatever. And he was saying some crazy stuff. And, but the whole premise was, to me, it was just, I don't know why it pissed me off so much, but it did. And it was one of those things where I was like, dude, this is the kind of thing that happens all the time. It compounds with these people. It happens over and over and over and over. And for me, I kind of just dodge a lot of this stuff. I live in a world that's pretty insulated from a lot of, this stuff. And, I don't know. I it feels crazy to me that these people would literally take to Twitter or Instagram and or Snapchat or whatever app they have and say things that are going to get them fired. It's always fascinating to me. You know, what I do here is I talk about the Ducks like a fan, and we just keep it about the Ducks, and we keep it about whatever's going on, or any other sport, even MMA or some sort of thing. We used to talk about all sorts of different stuff. But it's never a personal issue. And then, you know, with this guy who came in my tweet, it wasn't even a personal issue with him. But it was this idea that the way that I reacted was in such a way where I was like, it was not my normal way to react. And I got hooked. And it was like, you know, these guys get hooked all the time. These people get hooked on this all the time. And I talked to a guy who I work with who, he says, oh yeah, he says, I spend hours on Instagram chatting with these people back and forth, comments back and forth. He says, I'll wake up with hundreds of notifications. And I'm like, wow. I mean, I don't live that kind of life. No offense to the people who do. If they want to dive into that water, but that's just not me. So I appreciate all the Sports Chat fans out there. I try to make this show non-political at all, but this topic hit close to home because it was the U of O. I mean, I saw the thing right away. The guys were saying, hey, what U of O, what do you got to say about this? And I'm like, oh no, this is not what U of O needs right now. We're the number one team in the country, football-wise. Football is the front door of the whole university when it comes to the whole marketing and everything we have in our sports media right now that's completely blowing up. College football has never been more popular than it ever is right now. Here you have an election. Everybody's paying attention to the election. I mean, you're getting dang text messages after the election. I mean, come on. If you could have spent the money that you spent on TV ads for those elections, if you could have spent that money on the schools, if you could have spent that money on the roads, you could have built new bridges. You could have fixed the freaking water in places. I mean, it's crazy to me how much money is spent on these elections. And so people get wrapped up in it. And so I understand where these guys get all heated up. I just don't understand why you would take to, social media and just go crazy and literally threaten people. And that's what really pissed me off, I think, maybe at the end of the day. But this guy who came into my chat was, you know, he was like threatening violence. He's like, keep that energy when you come out here. I'm going to meet you. I'm going to blah, 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 blah. You know, it's like, I'm not with that life. That's not what I'm about. And it's not what we're about as a Sports Chat 503 community. So I appreciate everybody out there. Keep it positive. Keep your head above water. These are turbulent times, but it is what it is, man. If you like Trump, sweet. If you don't like Trump, I'm sorry. It things happen. You were excited when they had Biden, and then Trump will be out in 4 years. You'll probably have another Democrat in 4 years. That's kind of how the whole history of the thing works. And if you're super into politics, that's awesome. Because my whole family's all been politically active and politically interested and everything else like that. My son, I've always had conversations politically with him about what's going on. But I've never told him what to think. And I've never told him what to believe. And I think that's un-American. So these people that are threatening these people about if you voted for this person, blah, blah, that's exactly the opposite of what we're trying to do in this country. That's exactly the opposite. I just think people get hooked up into this thing big time. So had to speak on it a little bit. Thank you guys for watching Sports Chat 503. Stay safe out there, man. It's wild times. All right, guys. Appreciate you. As always, go Ducks.